Hey everybody, welcome back to our generator series. Today at the Great Outdoors RV Company, we are going to review the Briggs & Stratton P3000. Of course, this has been out for a while now too. It came out the same time as that 2200 they have. This can link together with that, with their parallel link kit, and there's a lot of features to talk about, and also the price is pretty good too. So stay tuned and we're gonna dive into this thing. Guys, now normally what we do is we do oil these up and gas them up for you to show you how to do that. But this is actually a demo unit that we already had in our showroom floor. So I will show you where to do those things, but we're not gonna do them today. So let's talk about the features on this unit. So first thing, you got grab handles, of course, up top. One of the nicest things though about this 3000 is that it has this telescoping handle here with wheels on the back, so you can wheel it around. Cause this is still 89 pounds, depending upon, of course, fuel and how much fuel you have in it. So having the wheels though is extremely nice. Now on the front panel, let me go over some of this for you here real quick. Okay, let's start on the very top. So here we got, of course, your gas fill, right? We open that up. In the past, we've seen, yep, they have a cord that holds the cap in place. You got a fuel filter down there, and you got a little red ring to show you where to stop filling up gas. But also you do have the gas gauge here, so you can see exactly how much gas is in this even while it's running, which of course you would expect on a 3000 watt. The other thing that's kind of nice is if you're like me and you're filling this thing up and you spill gas everywhere, you notice right here they actually notched the body of it a little bit just to provide a spot where you can pour off the extra gas. That way it's not just sitting here pooling. Okay, now on the control panel, a lot of things that we've seen on other generators are here, right? We have our ground, we have our check oil lights, we have our fault indicator, so the breaker, if the breaker gets thrown, and okay to run. Here you can switch views, here you can reset, has the eco mode, it has a 12 volt 5 amp outlet, so it's funny, a lot of them have 12 volt 5 amp outlets. The Yamaha did have a 12 volt 8 amp, if I'm not mistaken, which is kind of cool. But this right here will reset that for you. USB ports already built in. Now right here, you guys have the proprietary parallel link cable system from Briggs. So this is only gonna be usable with Briggs's in-house parallel link system. So it's not transferable among different generators. Not that I think that most people would do that anyways. Okay, and then right down here, you have your 120 volt 30 amp outlet. Now when we plugged the voltmeter into this, our techs found that it would, it actually kicked out 30 amps. This thing is touted as AC ready, AC capable, right? So this will power an AC unit for you. Unlike the other generators that we've reviewed, this is really truly the only one on its own that will do that at this point. Now you have four 120 volt 20 amp outlets. Now the actual generator itself on these outlets is rated to like 18.3, but they are 20 amp. Of course, that's going to be fine for just about anything you plug into this whatsoever. You don't typically need to max out the 20 amp plug. So okay, now with that said, I'd like to take you guys to the front. We'll open her up, show you where the fuel filter and all that other stuff is. Okay, you guys, now here's still the same instructions that we saw on the other Briggs. I guess it's a little better, but honestly, Octavia's gonna have to help me figure it out. So, okay, we got choke right here, and yeah, last time we got that all messed up, but this time we're gonna get it right. Okay, I'm gonna pop open the case here for you guys real quick. That's easy enough, two screws, pops out. Okay, so here is where you fill your oil at right there. Now this has already been filled with oil, but it does have the nice catch, which is awesome because we did end up, there was just a little bit of oil there left when, you know, some of our parts people had gotten this ready as a demo unit. So we just wiped that up really quick. And then over here, one screw will remove your air filter. There we go. So you got the two filters here and here, and of course they just pop out like that. All right. So now I'll put this back on. Let's see if I can actually do it right this time. There we go. And then we're gonna start this guy up and see how it all runs with the decibel test. And on the last video, a lot of you guys told us that we ran the choke for too long. All right, you guys, now we're gonna start this thing up for you. Now, I think I can understand the pictures well enough. I did go to public school though, so just bear with me real quick. Okay, let's go through the setup procedure here, okay? Step one, make sure there's oil and gas. That's check. Step two, turn the knob that away. So it needs to be in the horizontal position, not vertical. And then we're gonna do the choke. Last time I had the choke open like this, but this time we want it this way for closed. Now we just ran this so it won't actually be on choke for that long. And then we're gonna pull it and we're gonna take it off a choke. So, but before we do that, I wanted to get a decibel reading right now before we begin. Okay, so when my big mouth is quiet, it's about 57 decibels. We'll see here in a sec. So yeah, so it's anywhere from about 45 to about 53 decibels. Okay, now we're gonna crank this puppy up and see what happens. All sets, yes. Probably have to take it off a choke. Okay, now this is running not on the eco mode, so this is just at regular RPMs. All right, so right at about 75 decibels. Now we're gonna turn it on to the eco mode and see what changes. And my guess is, like other times, it won't do much. So it is fascinating, if you look here, okay, let's get a little closer, there we go. So that's about what we've typically seen. We've seen about 3, or I'd say even 2 to 4 decibels difference when a generator's on eco mode, so it's not a... It doesn't seem like much, but I can tell you when you're standing next to it, it is a big difference. All right, so now I'm gonna turn it off eco mode. We're gonna go stand about 20 feet away like we usually do and see what happens. All right, so we're gonna go to our normal spot right over here. This is very scientific research. Okay, so it's sitting right at about 60 decibels. So, you know, it's kind of like what we've seen with the other generators. Pretty equal, although I do like the fact that this is, of course, running at about the same loudness, but this one's ready to go for AC, so that's a huge bonus. All right, you guys, so kind of my final thoughts, if you will. There's a lot to like about this generator. I love the fact that it has the big rubber feet here on the bottom that we didn't show you guys earlier, but this right here, little shock absorbers to keep it, keep the noise of it rattling around down. I really like the fact that it has the wheels again. I love the little dolly handle that you can pull out to this level or you can go out all the way here. I mean, that makes moving it around so much easier. Especially if you had like something, a toy hauler, like a ramp, you can run it in and out. But all that means, all the only lifting you have to do with this is just get it out of your vehicle if you don't have a toy hauler. So that's fabulous. Of course, you know, it has a fuel gauge. We expect that on a 3000. I like the fact that it has the 4 plugs. I don't know how much of a big deal the parallel link cable that's proprietary just to Briggs is, because the more I think about it, the more I think about, well, when are you going to take your Yamaha link cable setup and hook it up to your Briggs? Probably never whatsoever. So I don't know if that's actually that big of a deal anymore. I will say this, we've had this on the floor for a little while. Briggs could put a better little lid on this if I'm getting nitpicky, because I can see there's cracking right here. I've already started on it. But besides that, I think it's okay. I don't like the fact that you have, this is not flush. That's again a little bit nitpicky. But the other thing I really don't like is I don't like the fact that you can't shut off the gas. I really enjoyed how the Yamaha had designed the gas shut off. That way you could, let the carburetor run dry. So in this one here, what you would need to do is you would need to add fuel stabilizer. You need to make sure that you run it with that stabilizer in there to get that it gets through the entire system as well. The grab handles are really nice and stout. And last but not least, I like the fact that they gave you the little trough right here to get any gas that you happen to spill while filling your tank off the top of this thing. The one other thing that we need to talk about is price, of course, though. So this thing here is, roughly, depending upon where you find it, what kind of deals you can get on it, right, it's going to be about $1,500 is what you're looking at. So by far, this is the most expensive generator that we reviewed on our channel at this point in time. Is it worth it? I would think so. If you are going to be camping in an RV, the idea is it's supposed to be convenient, right? Camping is supposed to be a little bit easier. So if you need something to power your AC, I would almost rather have this that I can cart around and it's just one unit that I have to worry about. If I needed space, if space was a requirement and I was kind of low on what space I would have, maybe I would consider doing two 2000s if I had to kind of, a smaller area to work with and I couldn't fit this big monster in whatever space I have available. But if I do have the space available, it's kind of nice to just keep this one unit and not have to worry about the rest. So honestly, I'd say that Briggs did a pretty good job with this. I am impressed at how quiet it was, how easy it was to kick on. Besides a few little details, I think that this is a really good option for our viewers. You guys, thanks for watching our videos. Again, we like these generator series. If you guys want to see us do something, please let us know in the comments. If you got feedback, like we saw last video, like we left the choke on way too long, please let us know. Let us know what we could do better, what you'd like to see. We're going to do more of these generator videos. We want to plug voltmeters up to them. We want to see kind of what they're kicking out. We also want to do an AC test. I really want to see the Predator return and face off against this thing and kind of see, since they're both, one's 4,000, one's 3,000, but I want to see where do those two actually match up at. So, anyways, we do a lot of RV videos on this channel, obviously. So if you guys like to see what new floor plans come out, consider subscribing, and hit that bell if you want to be notified as to when we put out new content. And, thank you guys for watching so much. We enjoy doing these. We'll see you guys next time.